from Wes. I'm Racy B from Elevate Manila.
And I'm Kyla E, also from Elevate Manila, guys. So welcome to the online youth service, and we are so excited that you guys are here. And if you are with us and you are new here in Elevate, why don't you comment down below new para we get to know you, para all of us masaya tayo lahat, guys.
Oo, totoo yan, totoo yan. And last week, we talked about open communication and how important it is to share to your family. And today, we will be talking about time and why won't you guys spend some time with me and Kala as we make our drinks for the service today. So, ang gagawin ko is, I'm gonna make iced coffee sa mug. Ayan, how about you, Kala? What will you make?
I'm gonna make Milo!
Oh my gosh, that's good. Oh, that's so good. Yes, kasi diba, parang binge watch tayo. We like having snacks and drinks. So, ganun lang din naman yun when we do our online service. Diba?
Mm-hmm. So guys, habang we're doing this, why don't you guys tag your friends and your family? And super sakto, kasi diba, what we're talking about is motivate or motivating the family. There are a lot of... It's a mnemonic, guys. So, why don't you tag your friends, your family, and while you're tagging them, we have a question for you guys that you can answer. And it is, how do you spend time with your family during the pandemic? So, ano yung mga bonding moments nyo? What have you guys been doing? Oh, sige, siguro to start, to keep the ball rolling, I'm gonna share muna. So, I'm not sure if you guys remember, but I hosted before and I said I wanted short hair talaga. And so what we did as a family, my dad, he cut my hair and my mom's hair. It turned out so well. Surprisingly, isn't ready na kami mag-contour that time. Kayo, Ate Razy, ano yung bonding niya ng family niyo?
I just wanna say, ang ganda ng hair mo. Like, hindi siya halatang ginawa sa bahay. And to be honest, like, isa sa mga inspiration ko why I wanted to cut my hair is because of ganda ng hair ni Kyla. Salamat, Shopee, sa pag-provide.
Good thing.
Sa mag-good thing. And speaking of shopping, diba, one of our bonding sa magkakapatid is we opened an online thrift shop in Instagram. So, follow us. Diba? So, iba't iba kasi four kami. So, one model, one's in charge of marketing, that's me, creatives, my brother's in charge with shipping, my ate's in charge with admin work. So, it's really nice to do something that we're very passionate about. And that's clothes. Diba? So, today, kasi may araw nga naman, di ba, today. Hello, Racy, ano na nangyari sa time mo, di ba? So, today, we'll be having our icebreaker called, What Time Is It?
Summertime!
Afternoon! Afternoon na! Di ba? So, mechanics ng game is we'll be asking you guys some questions. So, comment down below lang kung what time or how long nyo ginagawa to. So, first question is, how long does it take para makabangon ka sa bed? Diba? How about you, Kyla?
Next question. Pero, you know, we foster honesty. So, we're gonna answer honestly, guys. So, nag-alarm ako na 7 at Racy. Pero, pupabangon ako mga 9 o'clock.
Oh my gosh, so 2 hours. 2 hours. Nag-ano pa? Nag-reboot pa yung katawan mo nun.
Diba? Totoo.
Rebooting pa lang siya. Ako naman, I alarm at 9. Kasi I really wanna wake up early. Ganyan. But I wake up at 12. Ganyan. So pag tinanong sa akin, para saan ka bumabangon, Racy? Sa lunchtime ako bumabangon.
Very valid though.
Yes, yes. So, after mo kumain, syempre naliligo ka na, di ba?
Mm-hmm. So, yun yung next question natin, guys. Pagkatapos yung babakon, how long kayo naliligo? O, go, Ate Razy! Ano sagot mo dyan?
Zero minutes. Joke lang. Aminin nyo, guys. May iba sa inyo, hindi naliligo sa quarantine. Pero, huwag kayo mag-alala, naliligo naman ako. So, siguro mga 20 to 30 minutes. Pero now that short na hair ko, syempre nag-cut down na yung ano, shampoo time. Isang pump na lang ng hair.
Mas mabilis na siya hugasan, ganun. Okay. But after natin maligo, guys, yung next question naman natin is, gaano katagal magbukas o mag-restart yung laptop? O, diba? Parang,
oh my gosh.
After Ligo, ito na yung next.
Ito na. Marami nang matitrigger dito. Kasi, siguro may iba mga 1 hour, 30 minutes, minsan zero. Sira na yung laptop eh, diba? Sira na siya eh. Diba? Worst nightmare yan.
Oo. Diba? Comment yan, guys, below. Kasi, for sure, hindi kayo alone. Para you guys to, na may kasama kayo nagsa-struggle sa mga panahon na ito. And, hindi lang yung laptop nyo. Yung naglolokob. May mga ibang laptop din na naglolokob. Okay, yes. Next question.
Is how long do you cook your instant noodles? Yan, yung mga pansit canton natin, di ba?
That's true,
so,
that's true.
So, ikaw kala, how long ka nagluluto?
Oh, yeah. Kasi as Filipino families, di ba, mahilig talaga tayo magluto. Bagay sa iced Milo and sa iced coffee natin. Ako, I cook it siguro mga 2 minutes, the usual. And then after though, I fry it. And it's so good. And then sama nyo na yung mga packets na kasama. It's so good talaga. Life hacks! How about you, ate?
Grabe. Gordon Ramsay is shaking. Bobby says, who is Bobby says?
There's only Skyla is curious.
Yes. Top chef. Diba? So, ako, siguro mga 1 minute and 30 seconds. Specific, and 3 milliseconds. Joke. So, once na, naghiwari-walay na yung noodles, tinatanggal ko na siya sa stove. Kasi I don't want my noodles soggy. Diba? And we love eating. We're Pinoys, diba? So, very important yung meals. Nasa heart natin yan, guys. Diba? So, our last question is,
dun-dun-dun-dun! How long do you eat with your family? Pwedeng breakfast, lunch, dinner, gano'ng kabilis, or gano'ng katagal? Kasi bonding natin yung mealtime as very Filipino culture. Yes. Ikaw, Ate Ricky, kayo?
Kami siguro mga 20 to 30 minutes. 20, pag yung galit-galitan, pagod, hindi na nag-uusap, ganyan. And 30, pag you know, you're enjoying your time with your family, ganyan. How about you, Kyla?
Siguro pag lunch time, mga 1 hour, kasama na dun yung preparing, yung eating, pati yung dog namin na pinapakain namin. Kasi yun,
oh
sobrang
fun
yung yeah, so pag 1 hour, ginugulo lang din namin yung dog. Ayun. Okay. And speaking of families, while you guys are answering, yung may next kami sasabihin, like your family in Elevate. You know, Ate Racy and I, we're part of the same Dgroup family. Kasi Ate Racy's, here pala, Ate Racy's sister, Ate, is my Dgroup leader. So that's why right now, we're also bonding as a Dgroup family as we make our drinks for the online
meeting. Yes! Yes, and parang Dgroup is a place, to be honest, Dgroup is a very warm place to be na. You can be honest, you can pray with one another, encourage one another, really help with your walk with Christ. Yeah.
Mm-hmm, that's true. And speaking of that, pwede din kayo mag-bonding, diba, Ate Race? See?
Yes.
Yung mga bonding nyo, eating together, and also growing in your relationship with the Lord. Sa mga hindi pa part ng Dgroup dyan, Ate Race, how can you be part of a Dgroup?
That's a very good question, Kyla. So if you guys want to join a Dgroup, you can get connected with us by messaging our page in Elevate Metro West. Hi, Ate. Hi, Kuya. Wanna join a Dgroup? Or you can just sign up in our link in the description box. Or you can simply ask the person who invited you to put you in a Dgroup, diba? Kasi we would gladly help you to be part of a Dgroup kasi it's a very nice community to be in. And that's speaking true. Of, we are already done with our drinks.
I'm done!
Yes! Cheers!
Okay, since we are ready, our drinks are ready, I hope you guys are ready as well for the online youth service. So, for the last time, guys, see you guys next time. This has been Kyla E.
And this is Racy B. And we're signing off. Bye, guys!
Cheers!
Hello, Elevate! Welcome to our online youth service today. Let's just worship and give praises to our God today. Sabay-sabay natin kantahin ang kantang ito sa Kanya at paalala ang love at ang grace niya. So let's sing this to Jesus. Come on. Who breaks the power of sin and darkness? Whose love is mighty and so much stronger? The King of glory, the King above all kings. Come on. Who shakes the whole earth with holy thunder? And leaves us breathless in awe and wonder. The King of glory, the King above all kings. Let's sing this to Jesus, come on. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. You lay down your life. That I would be set free. Whoa, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me. Who brings our chaos back into order? Who makes the orphan a son and daughter? The King of glory, the King of glory. Who rules the nations with truth and justice? Shines like the sun in all of its brilliance. The King of glory, the King above all kings. Sing it out. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. Come on. You laid down your life. That I would be set free. Oh, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me. Let's declare this to our God. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Come on. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Come on. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Sing it out. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy, worthy, worthy. Oh, this is amazing grace. Oh, Lord, this is unfailing love. That you would take my place. Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me. Oh, 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 oh,
Hey guys, welcome back to our online youth service. If you're joining us for the first time, welcome. We're so glad you could be with us right now, and we hope you can just comment down below, new, or even just message this page. Just let us know that you are new here, and we'd love to get connected with you. We'd love to message you, get to know you more, and we hope you just have a great time with us. We're actually on the fourth week of our series called Motivate, and later, we're going to talk about time. Crazy to think about how time flew the past few months, kasi October na. We're 10 months into 2020. And so much has happened. Ang dami na nangyayari. Maybe some of us here are discouraged because of all that's happening sa bansa natin, sa pandemic, sa buong mundo. Maybe some of us are here discouraged because of what's happening sa pamilya, sa new normal, sa online classes, ang dami pinapagawa. Wala namang panggawa. Or maybe some of us here are honestly just feeling so lost and helpless because of all that's happening and you feel overwhelmed. Like you don't know what else to do in 2020. If that's you, I want to encourage you with this verse. It says in Joshua chapter 1 verse 9, "Have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous. Do not be frightened, do not be dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go." And God was talking to Joshua in this verse. And Joshua, just like many of us here, felt discouraged, felt lost because he didn't know what to expect. He didn't know how to face what he needed to face. But God encouraged him with this reality that he goes with us. How can we continue to face 2020? How can we continue to fight our battles? How can we realize that there is a hope? It's when we realize and remind ourselves of the truth that God is with us. So as we sing this next song, remind yourself of that. Of who has been there and who will continue to be there. And later, I will pray for you.
You were reaching through the storm, walking on the water, even when I could not see. In the middle of it all, when I thought you were a thousand miles away, not for a moment did you forsake me. Not for a moment did you forsake me. After all, you are constant. After all, you are only good. And after all, you are sovereign. Not for a moment did you forsake me. Not for a moment will you forsake me. You were standing in the dark, whispering your promise, even when I could not hear. I was held in your arms, carried for a thousand miles to show. Not for a moment did you forsake me. Not for a moment did you forsake me. And after all, you are constant. And after all, oh, you are only good. And after all, oh, you are sovereign. Not for a moment will you forsake me. Not for a moment will you forsake me. In every step, every breath, you are there. And every tear, every cry, every prayer. In my hurt, at my worst, when my world falls down, not for a moment did you forsake me. And every step, every breath, you are there. And every tear, every cry, every prayer. In my hurt, at my worst, when my world falls down, not for a moment forsake me. And after all, you are constant. And after all, oh you are only good, Lord. Oh, you are sovereign. Not for a moment will you forsake me. Not for a moment will you forsake me. Not for a moment will you forsake me. And after all, come on, you are constant. After all, oh, you are only good. And after all, you are sovereign. Not for a moment will you forsake me. Not for a moment will you forsake me.
Heavenly Father, Lord, we just want to thank you for this time. Thank you for your promise. Thank you for who you are. That you just never leave us and you never forsake us. That despite what we've been through the past few months, despite what we're going through right now, what we might feel or what we might even go through in the next few weeks or months, thank you because you never leave us. You never forsake us. You are always there with us, guiding us, leading us, helping us. And right now, Lord God, as we spend this time, would you be the one, Lord God, to use your speaker mightily? May it be your words and not his. Be the one, Lord, to teach all of us something new, that we might even apply it in our lives. And just bless this time, Lord God. Thank you so much. We're excited to hear from you. We love you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So to introduce our speaker, Metro West, he's actually the Metro South Hub Coordinator. He's been in full-time for many years, and he's no stranger to any of us. Let's all welcome our Kuya Dan Carandang.
Hi, Elevate Metro West. My name is Kuya Dan. Thank you so much for having me here. Thank you so much, Gabo, for inviting me. I'm so pumped up to be here with all of you right now. Just want to honor him, all the life coaches, all the leaders in Taft, Shaw, Manila, Makati, Bay Area, and all the other campus movements in that area of Metro Manila. Thank you so much for everything you're doing for young people. I'm just so excited for what God has in store for the campuses in your area. We're on the third installment of our series called Motivate. And in this series, we're looking at eight principles formed into the acronym Motivate that if we understand and live out, could change our lives and the lives of the people around us, our family members, our online classmates, our friends, our relatives. This is very relevant, especially to us today. And today we're going to talk about the third letter, T, which stands for time. I just want to begin by sharing a survey I did on Facebook and Instagram a few days ago. Basically, I asked the question, sabi ko, if you could go back in time, how would you change the way you spent January and February, knowing that there would be a lockdown beginning in March? Okay, pwede ba i-comment nyo yung mga answers nyo down below? Paano magbabago yung schedule nyo, the way you spent January and February, kung alam nyo pagdating ng March, may mahabang lockdown na paparating? Okay, thank you so much for everyone who answered, who participated. Really appreciate it. Let me just share with you some of the top answers I got. Top one answer, pinakamaraming sumagot nito. Sabi nila, if they knew, basically, na may lockdown na paparating, they would travel. Okay. Yung mga magta-travel dyan, kung alam nyo may lockdown, pwede ba magpaulang kayo ng heart reacts? Pwede ba i-comment nyo rin kung saan kayo pupunta? Sabi dun mga sumagot sa survey, Tagaytay, EK, Japan, Boracay, grabe. Sabi naman nung iba, top 2, if they knew that there'd be a lockdown starting March, they would meet up with friends. Okay. Sino nakaka-relate dito? Pwede ba paulang kayo ng sad reacts? You know, could you mention also the people you're gonna bond with? Sayang, ano, tambay, kahit na pasyal magkakasama, mall magkakasama, nakakamiss. Top 3 answer. Sabi nila, the way they would live January and February differently is they would dine in sa labas. They kakain sila sa labas. Nami-miss yun na ba to? Street food, di ba? Kahit normal na Jollibee, di ba? Yung mga iba, miss na miss yung Viking, Samboko Gin. Nakaka-miss. Top 4, sabi naman ni Carmela Batario, hahataw daw siya sa PE. Gagalingan daw niya sa school. Kasi hindi naaabot ng finals. And lastly, may mga iba sagot pa, but end ko na dito, no? Sabi nung iba, I guess, no? Kung may lockdown sa March, hindi na sila magkikita, aamin daw sila sa crush nila. May kilala ba kayong ganito? Pwede ba pa-thumbs up kung may kilala kayong ganito? Yung isang sumintak sa akin, yung comment ni Norma Mendoza from Elevate Ayala Mall South Park. Grabe, no? Si ano to? May naliligaw ba sa kanya? Tapos, aamin na siyang gusto rin niya. Kung kilala niyo si Ate Norma, tsaka kilala niyo yung may crush sa kanya, naliligaw sa kanya, pwede ba paki-comment yung pangalan niya? But let me ask you a question. Do you have regrets in the way you lived out January and February? If meron kayo mga gusto sana baguhin, pwede ba mag-comment kayo ng sad reacts? Ako meron. Meron akong mga regrets. Sana ginawa ko. Sana may pinuntahan pa ako. Sana I spend time with these people. You know, the reality is all of us allocated time, spent time on certain activities that seemed right to us, that we thought were right activities na pagugulan ng oras. Otherwise, hindi natin pinagugulan ng oras nung January tsaka February. But it's interesting that many of us, kung alam lang pala natin na magbabago yung buhay natin starting March, many of us would have changed the way we spend time during those months. The truth is, lahat tayo were spending time right now. Lahat kayo nanonood, we're allocating, investing, putting time in something right now. Nanonood kayo nito. Perhaps kumakain kayo habang ginagawa nyo to. We're all spending time. My question to us is this. Have you ever stopped to think or reflect on how you're spending time? Nag-stop ka na ba to think about saan ko ba nilalagay yung buhay ko? Saan ko talaga ginagugulo oras ko? Tama ba tong mga pinaglalagyan ko ng oras? Or are you just so caught up with everything that you need to do right now? Like marami sa inyo, online classes, house chores, and okay yun. Importante yon, but even, you know, yung ibang pinagugulan natin ng oras, like social media, or watching videos, TV, Netflix, YouTube, or doing recreational stuff like biking, or exercising, working out, nothing wrong with those things necessarily. Yung iba sa atin, yung mga pinagugulan pa natin ng oras, nagpapa-mythical glory sa ML, nagpapa-legendary sa COD. Have you stopped to think? How am I really using my time? Are these the right things to put my time into? Unlike money, yung time hindi mo na kikitain pabalik, hindi mo na siya mababalik. At time, when you spend it, you can't get it back again. You know, we need to understand that time is both precious and powerful. Powerful in that it can actually impact the world, the people around us. The way we spend time will dictate two things at least. It will dictate if we'll look back in life with regret or not, or if we'll impact people for good or not. That's why in our short time together, we're gonna answer the question, how should I really spend time? Saan ko ba dapat ginugugol yung oras ko? How can I spend time wisely? So that if I look back in my life, walang regrets. Wala akong dapat pala iba na lang ginawa ko. Kung pwede lang sana papalta ko schedule ko. Wala tayong ganun. How should we spend time also in a way that will hopefully pave the way for the people around us, our family members, our online classmates, our relatives, our friends, our neighbors? Paano tayo makapag-spend ng time that will pave the way for these people to experience breakthroughs in their lives? Okay, so are you excited? If you're excited, could you give me a thumbs up in the comments? I'm so excited to share all these things with you. But before we continue, can we just pray real quick? Let's just commit this time to God. Lord, thank you so much for this time together. Thank you so much that it was never a coincidence, never an accident that we're watching this. And I pray that you will help us to know how to properly spend time, how to live a life that we're gonna have no regrets. And that we're gonna impact, Lord, the people around us. That it's gonna pave the way para ma-experience nila yung breakthrough sa buhay nila. I pray, Lord, for everyone watching who's hurting, everyone discouraged, everyone na hindi okay sa pamilya, everyone part of a dysfunctional or broken family, everyone depressed, everyone who's fatigued because of their online classes, that as we listen to the preaching of your word, Lord, they will find the rest, the encouragement, the peace, the healing, the guidance, the wisdom that they need, that they're longing for. Just help me, Lord, explain all these things clearly and thank you in advance for what you're about to do in our hearts. In Jesus' name we pray, and everyone said a big, big amen. Amen. So the first thing we need to understand about time is that it's passing, okay? Lost time is lost forever. Could you please comment down below, lost time is lost forever. Lost time is lost forever. You know, I came across this video on Facebook of a truck na may kinakalagkad na kotse sa expressway sa California, nakakita na ba kayo ng ganito sa talambuhay nyo? Grabe, alam nyo, it's crazy. The people there were waving at the driver, even yung tao doon sa loob ng kotse, tinatry nilang kunin yung attention ng driver, but it took them 6 kilometers, more than 6 kilometers, bago sila napansin ng driver ng truck. So, tinabi niya yung truck, tapos nakakatawa, hindi daw alam ng driver. Hindi niya alam na meron siyang kinakalagad na kotse. It's really crazy. Kawawa, diba? Grabe yung nangyari dun sa kotse. But you know, I was just thinking about the driver of the car. You know, it was a dangerous situation. I'm sure he wouldn't have wanted to be there. He wanted to get out of it. He didn't wanted to continually, you know, be hooked to that truck. Pero wala siyang magawa, di ba? Yung kotse nakasabi doon sa truck eh, talagang sunod lang siya doon sa under ng truck. Hindi siya makaalis. Hindi niya kaya magpaiwan. And you know, I realized that's a picture of the unstoppable nature of time sa atin in relation to us. You know, parang itong orasan na to, tignan niyo yung second hand, tuloy-tuloy andar niya. Yan, may isang segundo, they just passed. Another second. I mean, tuloy-tuloy yung oras eh. You can't make it pause. You can't make it stop. Kahit tanggalin mo ng baterya, lahat ng orasan sa buong mundo, time will just keep going and going and going. Does it really matter if you like it to go or not, or if you spend it properly or not, time will just keep passing by. And the moment it's passed by, that time that has passed by is lost forever. Sabi ni Moses kay God, Psalm chapter 9 verse 12, sabi niya, "Teach us to realize the brevity or the shortness of life so that we may grow in wisdom." See, the reality is if we realize how short life is on earth, how concise our life is on earth, the time we have, the moment we're born to the time we die, then we're gonna spend time wisely. You know, marami na akong regrets sa area na to, especially sa family namin. One example is with my grandfather. And here's a picture of me and my lolo nung bata pa ako, no? Like, second father ko talaga to. When I was young, siya yung maghatid sundo sa akin sa kinder. Punta kami sa South Supermarket na dating part pa ng Alabang Town Center. Architect kasi siya, so sasama niya ako sa mga job sites, sa hardwares, bilihan ng tiles. Tinuruan niya ako mag-sketch, mag-drawing. Lumaki ako ng konti, siya nagturo sa akin mag-drive. Pero nung naging high school ako, that's when it started. I became too busy for him. I busied myself with, you know, other priorities, other things, activities rather. Banda, varsity, basketball, girlfriend. Bukod to sa mga kailangan ko talaga kong gawin. Katulad ng group projects, you know, group work practices. Pagdating ko ng college, nag-dorm ako. So tuloy yung banda, girlfriend, extracurriculars, events, concerts. When I became a young professional, I busied myself with work. It's really my fault. Until I realized na tumanda na siya. And until nabedridden na siya, I'm actually thankful for the fact na dito siya nakatira sa amin. So bago ko umalis, kaya ko magpaalam sa kanya. Nakita ko siya halos araw-araw noon na ospital siya. I was able to spend time with him. But looking back, the truth is I could have spent more time. I could have spent more time, you know, walking with him pag nagpapatay siya ng aso, just spending time with him, looking over photo albums, asking about his life, about how the war was, learning from him, just bonding with him. Sayang. Sayang, 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 sayang. Pero ang totoo niyan, because time has passed, kahit na umiyak ako, kahit na pagsisihang ko, umagos luha ko, hindi ko na babalikan eh. Hindi natin mababalikan yung mga dumaang oras. Time is passing. That's why we must live out, you know, use time, spend time, allocate time wisely. Time is passing, and time lost is lost forever. Okay, if you got what I said, could you please type, come on. Second principle about time we need to understand is that time isn't just passing. Time also has a purpose. Okay, and for followers of Christ, if you believe in Jesus, you know, we need to spend time to fulfill God's purpose in our lives. Now, second principle is this. Time has a purpose. It's not just passing. Time has a purpose. And the purpose of time is actually to fulfill God's purpose in our lives. Okay? You know, yung Apple, which is better than something. Apple released a new set of iPads, I think a couple of weeks ago, including the iPad Air, yung may iba-ibang color. And I did some research, around 3,000 to 34,000, almost 34,000 pesos to sa Pilipinas. It's a high-tech device with lots of high-tech features. You know, you can communicate with people all over the world, use it to edit photos and videos and music and make sketches and play games. High-tech to, ang dami mong pwedeng gawin. But can you imagine if someone comes across your iPad, tapos hindi niya alam yung purpose nito, sabi niya, may pwesto kayo sa palengke, ako, okay to, pwedeng chopping board to. So, kinuha nung tao sa bahay niyo, nagtatandad siya ng pata doon, dun yung screen ng iPad, yung chopping board niya. Or can you imagine, umuulan, nagtawag kayo ng karpentera para tulungan kayong takpan yung tulo sa bubong, tapos sabi, anong pwedeng pantapal dito, di ba, wala na kayong sealant, di ba, ito, pwede to, sir. Tapos pinako yung iPad mo dun sa yero sa bubong nyo. It's not funny, right? It's tragic. Kasi ang dami mo pa sana nagawa, 'di ba? Ang dami mo pa sana na paggamitan doon, na maximize mo pa siya for other things. Had that person, had those people just understood what the purpose of that iPad is. You see, the truth is, just because we're using something doesn't necessarily mean we're using it properly. And the same is true with time. Just because we're using time, just because we're busy doesn't mean we're spending time properly. Okay? Just because we're busy doesn't mean we're spending time properly. In Ephesians chapter 5, verses 15 to 17, the Bible says, "Look carefully then how you walk or how you live. Not as unwise, but as wise, making the best use of the time because the days are evil. Therefore, do not be foolish, but understand." Could you type understand? "Therefore, do not be foolish, but understand what the will of the Lord is." The purpose of time is to fulfill God's purpose in our lives. Just a short background on this. You know, the Ephesians were formerly pagans. The book of Ephesians in the Bible is actually a letter to the church, the followers of Jesus in the city called Ephesus. Yung passive na mga immoral na tao to, very unholy life, and that was my life before, you know. But you know, I just to paint a picture of it, I remember in 2008 was the first time I was able to visit Las Vegas, and it's really a sin city. Literally, pagka pumunta ka doon, the billboards, the signages, the LED screens, yung mga promotions, it's really all about sex, gambling, pleasure, prostitution. There was even one infamously memorable time wherein naglalakad kaming apat, family namin, ako, sister ko, tatay ko, nanay ko. Tapos may namimigay ng mga cards sa amin. Hindi siya leaflet para sa one by one na milk tea, hindi siya leaflet para sa discount. Pag tinignan mo yung binibigay na card, may babae nakabrat panty doon, tapos may number. They're actually calling cards for prostitutes. And just imagine giving it to a family, giving us cards for prostitutes. That's a picture of the ancient world, you know, the immorality of the ancient world. That's the past life of these Ephesians. But now that they've come to know Jesus, now that they've received forgiveness for their sins, now that they've received a new life, it should change the way they live, including the way they should spend time. And, you know, I tried to do some research and I tried to study Ephesians 4 and chapter 5. The moments and opportunities God opens up for them, kailangan iba na rin the way they live their lives. And even the moments and opportunities God opens for them, dapat iba na yung pag-google nila ng oras. And that has to be the same for us as well, who know Jesus, who have received this forgiveness in our lives. You know, I tried to look at Ephesians 4 and 5 and I tried to list down yung contrast. Kung dati ganito yung pinagugulan nila ng oras, ngayon sa bago nilang buhay in Christ, ano na yung dapat na pinaglalagyan nila ng oras? Kung dati, for example, impurity, yun yung buhay nila, you know, pleasure. Ngayon, dapat it's about righteousness. If before their life was lived for lust, it should now be lived for holiness. Kung dati yung buhay nila was lived for deception, yun yung umuubos na oras, yun yung lifestyle nila. Dapat it's now about sacrificially laying down their lives to fulfill the call of God for them. Kung dati yung buhay nila, you know, yung oras nila was put in obscene stories, foolish talks, coarse jokes, dapat ngayon it's about talking about the thankfulness to God. If before they were excusing sin in their lives, in their lifestyle, now their lives should be consumed as living as lights in the world. They're living for what's good and right and true. If before it was about participating in worthless deeds of evil, ngayon, kailangan yung buhay nila was now about exposing and reproving these deeds of evil. It's a totally different life. Now, it's about the purpose of God in their life. Yung oras nila, ngayon may purpose na ako for living, may purpose na oras ko, may mission na akong kailangan accomplish sa lahat ng gagawin ko sa mundo. Are you getting what I'm saying? Could you please type, come on? You know, meron akong pinsan na best friend. May ganun din ba kayo? Could you please give me a heart react sa comments? A heart react or a heart heart emoji sa comments. Eto, bata pa lang kami, close na kami. Talagang we would sleep over either sa bahay nila o sa bahay namin dito. Laro sa putek, you know, basketball, kung computer games, StarCraft. Kung may nakakaalam pa noon nung game na yon, StarCraft 1, give me a thumbs up. Close talaga kami. And it was his wedding last February sa Ilocos. And for those of you who know me, I love to travel. I was also excited about Ilocos. It's a nice place. But you know, more than just having a good time, more than just having a vacation, I knew God had placed a burden in my heart. You know, He placed a burden in my heart to befriend, to engage the other groomsmen so that I can share Jesus to them. And so from the moment the bus arrived, you know, sumakay ako ng bus sa Manila all the way to Ilocos, nung nakilala ko na ibang groomsmen, I took the opportunities to befriend them, to talk to them, to eat with them, to bond with them. You know, I did my best. You know, I really prayed na hindi ako parang weird or obnoxious na parang grabe to, ang banal naman ito. But I just really wanted to be their friend so that I could build a relationship with them and I can tell them about what Jesus did in my life. You know, merong, before the wedding, na-invite ako sa isang GC and nandun yung ibang groomsmen and may in-organize silang bachelor party. May mga babae, may mga alak. And nung nandun, dahil nga, thankfully, naging, you know, tropa nila ako and they were trying to convince me, Dan, sama ka na, wala namang mangyayari. Alam mo yun, may babae lang, magsasayaw. Parang ganun. And ako, parang iniisip ko, baka okay lang naman, you know? Parang, baka okay lang naman, wala namang mangyayari masama, di ba? Kailangan ko naman sila ma-reach out, di ba? Parang ganyan. But you see, the reason why I befriended, why I spent time with them wasn't for me to merely be liked. It wasn't for me to be accepted, you know? It was, those were just means para masabi ko si Jesus sa kanila. And, you know, thankfully, God reminded me of the mission. You know, nung kinoconsider ko na sasama ba ako sa bachelor's party. And God gave me the words to say. He gave me a way of escape. He moved their hearts and hindi na ako pilitin. And until ngayon, I'm still in connection, you know, with some of them. More than just enjoying the wedding and being there for my cousin, God gave me an opportunity to witness to them, to build a relationship with them. Live for God's purpose for your life. You see, the truth is, even people who don't know God, even though people who don't have Jesus in their lives, they spend time with people. They spend time in cause. They allocate time. Diba? Maraming tao ngayon, they get involved in cause like save the dolphins, save the ocean, save the forest. And there's nothing necessarily wrong with those things. However, what sets us apart, what should set us apart, no matter what venture we enter, no matter where we put our time, is the different set apart mission that God has given us as His people. Okay? To tell the world about Him. Kaya nga ngayon, kung nakilala mo na si Lord, dapat nag-iiba na yung priority mo, yung ultimate goal mo sa mga ginagawa mo. Kung before, sasali ka ng org just for the sake of community, you know, to be part of something, malagay mo sa resume. Now that you've received the forgiveness of Christ in your life, now it's more than just to have a community, it's to influence them for God. Now, when you go through your online classes, it's more than just to have a high grade, it's more than just para hindi ka magkaroon ng academic gap. Hindi lang para magawa. Hindi, gagawin ko yon so that I can reach out. I can reach out to more people. I can witness to Christ for them. I can shine, you know, sa mga group project. Makikita nila kaibahan sa akin. And hopefully through that difference, that excellence, they will want to know what I have. You know, when you bond with friends, you know, pagka pwede na ulit gumala, you go to outings and team buildings, more than just enjoying the scenery, you know, it's so that you can reach out. You can help them. You can minister to them. You can pray for them. You can encourage them. And hopefully, you can tell them about Jesus. When you spend time with your family, it's more than just, you know, earning points with them. You know, being a good shot. It's modeling to them what it means to be a Christ follower. It's so that you can help disciple them. Help them learn about the ways of God. You can inspire them, encourage them. Now our purpose is Christ's purpose because we have received the forgiveness of Jesus in our lives in spite of all our sins, in spite of all the things we've done against Him. He died on the cross for us. And as our soul, because He's given us a new heart, forgiveness, a new life, a fresh new start. And Lord, right now, the way I spend my time is no longer about me. It's now about You. Okay? Spend time to fulfill God's purpose in your life. Okay? So, time is passing. Lost time is lost forever. Time also has a purpose. It's to fulfill God's purpose in our lives. And last but not the least for our time together, third thing we need to understand para yung time natin, wala tayong regrets, the way we spend it, we need to practice. We need to practice wisely spending time now. Could you please type now with as many exclamation points as you can. Type nyo now sa comment section. Ilan sa inyo dito nakasakay na kayo ng aeroplano in the past? Could you give me a thumbs up? Okay, mga nakaka-miss lalo sa air travel. whether domestic or international. Last 2015, around that time, I had the opportunity to visit Palawan with my father and my sister. And nauna na sila doon, so hahabol ako. Mag-isa lang akong lilipad. And punta ako sa NAIA, punta ako sa check-in counter para sa gamit ko, security checks. Then, maaga pa ako, nakarating na ako doon sa boarding gate. Yun yung entrance, papasok nung parang tunnel, papasok ng aeroplano. And since maaga pa ako, sabi ko para ma-experience ko yung full airport experience, kakain muna ako. So punta ako sa isang place doon, bumili ako ng siopaw, iced tea, just trying to enjoy the airport moment. Wala ka naman sa airport araw-araw unless doon ka nagtatrabaho, diba? However, sadly, doon pala kung nasaan ako nakaupo, hindi rinig yung announcement. And hindi ko alam na 15 minutes before the departure time or yung time na aalis sa aeroplano, hindi na pwedeng pumasok, sinasara na nila yung door. Siguro for other pre-flight preparation. So, akala ko may time pa ako. So, pagkaubos ko ng pagkain ko, sarap na sarap ako. Pumunta ako sa boarding gate only to find out, sarado na yung gate. So, sabi ko, ma'am, paano to? Hindi na ba pwede? Hindi na daw talaga pwede. Naiwan ako ng aeroplano. Hindi lang bus o jeep. Aeroplano yung nakaiwan sa akin. No? I was just thinking, ano, parang tinatawag na pala nila ako, di ba? Sa PA, lahat na ginamit na nila, 'di ba? Mr. Karandang, you know, Daniel Pogi, Daniel Pascual, 'di ba? Mr. Pogi, Mr. Guapo, 'di ba? Nagtatawag na siya pero hindi ko marinig. sorry. And because I wasn't watchful, I wasn't paying attention, naiwan ako ng eroplano and I suffered the consequence of it. I realized that's a picture of what can happen to us if we don't understand these principles about time. If we fail to take to heart the fact that it's passing, that it actually has a purpose, and if we delay what we need to do in light of those things, we can assume na may time pa, we can relax and chill and delay and procrastinate until it's just too late. Okay? Understand that just because we're young doesn't mean that tomorrow is a certainty. Just because you're young doesn't mean that tomorrow or later will come. Sabi dun sa verse na binasa natin kanina, look carefully then how you walk or how you live. Not as unwise but as wise, making the best use. Everyone type best use. Making the best use of the time because the days are evil. If you don't act now, if you don't obey now, if you don't do what God is telling you to do now, you may never have the chance to do it because later or tomorrow may not come, both for you or for the people around you. You know, I was reminded of this good friend of mine, si Kylie Flores. Have her permission to share this story. She's one of the original leaders of Elevate Alabang many years ago. July 18, 2015, I was preparing for a talk like this and she calls me. She was crying. And apparently that morning, her mother, si Tita Aloha, which I also knew, naputukan ng ugat sa ulo, nagkaroon aneurysm. And then they rushed her to the hospital. Thankfully, nakapag-usap pa sila ng konti. But pagbalik niya, pumutok ulit yung ugat. And that was it. I went to the hospital the next day. Lumaki na yung ulo because the heart kept pumping and pumping blood. And they couldn't operate because the blood pressure, I guess, at that time was unstable and she later died. But you know, I was talking with her yesterday. That morning, according to her, there wasn't anything unusual. Yung siguro unusual doon, kumpleto sila. Kumakain sila, masaya sila, they were laughing. May mga lakad sila that day. Yung tatay niya magpapaayos sa sasakyan, sila magkakapatid. Tatlo silang magkakapatid. Siya, si Colleen, si Kelly, may mga lakad sila. They never imagined that would happen that day. It was just a normal morning, waking up for Kylie. And then, yun na pala yung araw na huli niya makakausap yung nanay niya. Yun na pala yung huling tawanan. Yun na pala yung huling usap. Mabigat, no? Yun na pala yun. You know, maraming ganun eh. Lalo na ngayong COVID. Yun na pala yung huling yakap. Huling usap. Kaya nga, pag ako lumalabas ako ng bahay, inalikan ko yung nanay ko, sa pisngin, niyakap ko siya, lola ko. Kasi, paano kung nagka-COVID ako? Hindi ko na sila mayakap eh. Kunyari, mag-grocery ako, may kailangan akong gawin, niyakapin ko muna mahigpit nanay ko kasi pwedeng yun na yung huli. Yun yung realidad eh, mga kapatid eh. My question to you is the way you're spending time today setting you up for regret tomorrow? Yung pag-google mo ba ng mga segundong dumadaan sa buhay mo ngayon, posibleng pagsisihan mo kung hindi na dumating yung bukas? Kaya nga, as we end, ano, kailangan we spend time wisely now. Like, for example, sa family, you know, I sympathize with you. Marami sa inyo, ayaw nyo makasama yung pamilya nyo. You don't eat together. You don't really like each other. Hindi ka nagpapansin ang mga kapatid mo. Nanay mo may ibang pamilya. Tatay mo may ibang pamilya. Dysfunctional yung family mo. Galit ka sa tatay mo. Ayaw mo silang makasama. And, ang hirap niyan. But, I just want you to think about paano kung inalaw ni God mangyari yan para turuan kang matutumag, magpasensya, magpatawad. What if more than just changing them, God wants to change you? Kaya nga, you need to obey God now. You need to forgive now. You don't wait until you feel ready. Forgive now. Apologize now. Mag-sorry ka na ngayon na. Mag-express ka na mahal mo sila ngayon na. Spend time ngayon na. Serve them ngayon na. Make things right ngayon na. Don't delay. Itama mo yung mga kailangan, tama. Sabihin mo na yung mga kailangan sabihin ngayon na. Or for example, sa spiritual family, sa small group mo, yung iba sa inyo, if you're joining us for the first time, a small group, it's a group of men, a group of women, and they're a group of imperfect people who are there to pray with you, to help you understand the Bible, help you learn to pray, help you walk with God. There's no perfect small group. But don't wait, ano mo yun, na hindi ka na awkward. Don't wait na feeling mo okay na ka na before serving them, before loving them, before caring for them, before affirming them, yung mga kasama mo sa church. Don't wait. Affirm now. Encourage now. Huwag mo nang hintayin bago maging okay ka. Mag-serve ka na. Alam nyo, may isang sumagot sa survey, sabi niya, kung alam lang niya na may lockdown sa March, mag-attend siya ng youth service. Parang event na to bago mag-lockdown. Kasi hindi niya alam na hindi na pala siya, alam niya na mawawala yung youth service for a long time. Serve now. Get involved now. Yung mga iba sa inyo na matagal na nawala, bumalik ka na now. Huwag mo na hintayin. And lastly, you know, perhaps sa mga friends, so connect with them now. Reach out to them now. Naalala ko, had the privilege, I think this is the other year, in-invite ako ng mga kaklase ko nung high school sa isang reunion Christmas. To be honest, hesitant ako to be there. Medyo awkward ako. Nahihiya ako eh. Kasi nung high school, sa mga ugali ko. Ang yabang ko. Marami akong atraso sa mga taong yon. Minura, sinigawan yung isa pa doon. Kabanda ko dati. Tinanggal ko siya sa banda dahil ang taas ng tingin ko sa sarili ko. Natapakan ko pa yung gitara niya tapos hindi ko binalik. But I knew, I believe, God had a burden in my heart to connect with them at that time. So kahit na medyo nahiya ako, medyo hesitant ako, pumunta ako. And, you know, while I was there, I just tried to befriend them. Tried to talk with them, know them. Ang bait nga nila sa akin eh. And, you know, while I was there, just, I wasn't trying to look holier than them. I was just trying to be real. Just trying to build a relationship. Apologize. Like, sorry ako, make things right. Halata nila na may nag-iba sa akin. Ang ganda, yung taong yon na may atraso ko, hinatid pa niya ako, sila mag-asawa, hinatid pa nila ako sa bahay nung gabi. And that wouldn't have happened. Ngayon, I'm still in connection, you know, with them. And that wouldn't have happened if I did not obey God now, at that time. Practice wisely spending time now. So as we end, let me ask you a question. How are you spending your time? Remember, time is passing. Lost time is lost forever. Time also has a purpose. It's to fulfill God's purpose in our life. You need to practice wisely spending time. So honor God with the way you spend time. Okay? Let me just pray for you. Lord, thank you for the Bible, that there is a reliable guide for the way we live our life. I just pray, help us to realize the shortness of our life and the purpose you have for us individually and as a spiritual family. And just give us the courage, Lord, the strength to obey you, do the things that you're asking us to do now. I just want to pray for a group of people here. You know, as you know, you cannot trust someone you don't know. You can't really obey someone you don't trust. The Bible says that God loves you. He loves you. But because of our sins, we're separated from Him. There is no relationship. Para kayo nasa dalawang kwarto ni Lord, walang usap, walang friendship, walang fellowship, walang bonding. That explains why no matter how much of an achiever you are, whether sa games, sa studies, you know, marami may gusto sa'yo, influencer ka, if you don't have Jesus in your life, you're empty because you're separated from the one who alone can give true meaning and purpose and fulfillment and happiness. And when we die, if we don't have Him in our lives, we will surely go to hell forever and ever. No one and nothing can take us out of that place. We're doomed, we're helpless, we're hopeless in our sins. But 2,000 years ago, Jesus came and died on the cross and paid for those sins. And 3 days afterwards, he rose again from the dead, proving he's really the Son of God. He's really the Savior of the world. And when you humble yourself and surrender before him as Lord, and he becomes your Savior, he allows you to experience that forgiveness in your life. He sets you free from that life of sin. Dati ganun yung life ko eh. Kahit saan ako dalhin ng temptation, ng galit, ng puot, sumusunod. Pero he will set you free and he will give you an assurance that you will go to heaven. Not because of what you've done, but because of what he's done. So, if that's you, if you don't know Christ personally, if you are not sure where you're gonna go when you die, then pray this prayer with me. This is not a magic mantra. This is the prayer of someone who wants to surrender his or her life to Jesus. Follow after me. Sabi mo, Lord Jesus, thank you for loving me. Thank you for dying on the cross and paying for my sins. Sabi mo, Lord, please forgive me for everything I have done against you. Sabi mo, Lord, from now on, you're now my master, and I believe you alone can save me. Then sabi mo, Lord, thank you for your promise that I'm now forgiven. I now belong to you, and I will be with you. Sabi mo, Lord, help me to love you. Help me to know you. Help me to obey you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. If you made that decision, please make sure to message us. Thank you so much, everyone. Thank you for joining us. See you again next week. Love you guys. God bless you all.
Man, what a message. Really, what a gift time is. And what a limited resource it is as well. We need to spend our time wisely. We need to understand that it's a blessing. And we need to spend more time with the people who really matter, our families, especially in this new normal. And I'm excited to spend time with my breakout groups to process the breakout questions, which is going to be flashed right after this. But if you're here and you don't have a breakout group yet, maybe you want to process it with somebody, maybe you have some questions, maybe you just want someone to talk to right now, feel free to just message this page. We'd love to get connected with you. And don't be shy. We hope you can just message this page. Also, if you think na kailangan marinig to na ibang tao yung video na to, yung message na to, feel free to just share it also sa timeline ninyo. Go ahead. Share nyo sa mga group chats ninyo, sa PMs, sa mga friends ninyo as well. Go ahead. Also, we're gonna continue this series. We're gonna be on week 5 of our Motivate series next week. It's gonna be a Saturday as well. So invite your friends, invite your classmates, invite your family members as well. And we hope to see you then. So yun lang. God bless as we break out into our breakout groups. And these are the process questions as well. See you guys next week.